Not here to hate. I'm here to point out some important stuff that you might not have thought about. We get asked about intuitive eating a lot. So what is intuitive eating anyway? It's the idea that after you've been tracking macros for a while, and sometimes there's people who don't track macros at all and they'll try to get into intuitive eating, and they think if I just listen to my body, I will somehow know through intuition and instinct what to eat, and I'll be able to maintain my optimal body composition and health by doing that. However, there are more holes in that theory than there are in SpongeBob SquarePants. One of the first things that you want to look at when assessing the flaws that are in intuitive eating and eventually figuring out who it could work for is think about the place that we are in history as it comes to human beings, activity, food, and all that other stuff. We're going to go here to my favorite tool, the whiteboard. And we're going to look at a couple little things that have changed over time. So starting at ye olde days, going up till now, one of the things that you'll notice is that activity level has dropped off. And so that's represented by this curve right here. So over time, as things became more industrialized and technology picked up, a lot of the work that people do transitioned into just sitting down and being sedentary instead of working with your hands, building things, working out on farms, in a more like agrarian society that people used to live in by and large. And also another thing too that's pretty interesting to look at is how the internal combustion engine and transportation led to people walking a lot less. I'm not just talking about people at Walmart or Target who will drive for 20 minutes trying to find the closest spot to avoid walking. This has to do more with commuting to an office where you walk a couple feet, sit down, stay there for 8-9 hours, and then go back home, sit down on your couch and watch TV. There's a lot less movement these days than you would see in the past. And another thing that's changed is the type of food that we eat. So the food that we eat now is a lot more calorically dense, it's highly palatable, and your intuition and instinct is gonna have you wanna eat more of it, because that's what instinct is based off of, is your evolutionary survival mechanisms that got your genes to where they are today. So when you combine these two things, more calorically dense, less filling food, with a sedentary lifestyle, which is a pretty broad brush that all humanity has been painted with at this point, you're gonna wind up having a lot of weight gain, which is what got people to where they are. And so that's the first point that I wanna bring up, is intuitive eating pretty much got people to the point where they would need to start tracking macros in the first place. And so going back to that is probably not gonna work out very well. Intuitive eating actually requires a ton of discipline, because if you're not tracking, you're not really gonna know where you're at and what your average intakes are from week to week, day to day, so on and so forth. So when you're going about your day and you feel a little bit of hunger, intuition is gonna have you pick up whatever it is around you and eat. You walk past the candy bowl at the office, say intuition is gonna wanna have a Reese's cup. You go out with your friends and have a few beers and they're starting to get food truck snacks, intuition is gonna have you get a street taco. So if you're just following your intuition and going about your life day to day, odds are you're gonna start racking up tons and tons of calories. And even if you're a creature of habit who's eating the same kind of things over and over again, because let's say that you were tracking diligently in the past and you've kind of established what your baseline week looks like and your baseline daily diet looks like, even if weekly or bi-weekly you're still having these big blowout sessions where you go over by thousands of calories over your maintenance, you're gonna start to see weight pile back on over time. And over the course of a year, you could be in a pretty bad spot. And you'll find yourself needing to really tighten things up. So why is intuitive eating so popular anyway? There's three things that have really popped up that we can see that really are the common threads. The first one is it seems like it's easy. And as we just went over, it's really not. It's easy to mess up because you're just kind of going off of what your instinct and intuition is telling you. And the whole idea here is you remove thought and you remove effort, but in removing thought and removing effort, you're removing accuracy. And by removing accuracy, you're probably going to remove a good result. So that's not really going to work out very well. So while easy might be something that draws people, well, easy is what got you where you are. That's not good. And in the same thread as being easy, it also seems like it can help you avoid effort. So we'll put effortless. Let's think of other areas in life where not putting in any effort yields a good result. Relationships, Probably not. Finances? Probably not. You really can't think of too many spots in life where not putting in effort yields a good result. So why would it be any different with your diet? Well, I'll give you a secret here. It's not. The next one has to do with this anti-diet culture movement that's popped up. And there's a lot of things about diet culture that I think are kind of terrible and suck. But the fact of the matter is, when people are unhealthy due to their weight, they need to do something differently to get back to a healthy spot where they're being enabled by their bodies instead of being trapped inside of them. If you want to link diet culture to all of the nonsense that we're so used to hearing from the fitness industry, then heck yeah, let's be anti-diet culture too. But if diet culture means that we're just trying to help people live the fittest and happiest lives possible, I'm totally for diet culture. So what you got to do is kind of find, take the good, get rid of the bad here. So if you want to talk about the whole diet culture thing, not my best handwriting, but it'll have to work. But if you really want to kind of hone back in on that whole diet culture thing, you should be happy with who you are as a human being, and you really shouldn't define who you are as a human being by what your body looks like. However, if your body is preventing you from being happy, like I was saying earlier, and preventing you from being healthy and experiencing all the great things that life has to offer, then you shouldn't be okay with that, and you shouldn't try to trick yourself that you are because, oh, well, there's this diet culture thing that's trying to tell me how I should be. But, you know, being winded every time you go up a flight of stairs is not good. Constantly having joint pain, not being able to breathe at night, and dying early is not body positive. That's destructive, and it's hampering your experience as a human being. So fitting it in with the whole anti-diet culture thing, that doesn't really work either. So can intuitive eating work for anyone? Yeah, it can. And it can work for people who have been tracking macros diligently for a long time, and they really know what their needs are. They've monitored and measured their body's response to different types of intakes. They have a clear understanding of what different portions are, and they're very diligent and conscious when it comes to monitoring things. Now, the funny thing about this is intuition is more along the lines of being instinctual and thoughtless. However, the people who are intuitive eatingly successful are thinking about what they're eating, and they're consciously thinking, am I getting enough protein? Is this too many carbs? Is this too many fat? The only difference is they're just kind of eyeballing and estimating constantly. So is true intuitive eating the type that works, even the type of intuitive eating that most people are drawn to? Probably not, because it does require a lot of discipline, so it's not effortless. And I wouldn't say it's easy either, because it requires that mental discipline to not grab a Reese's cup out of the snack bowl every time you walk by it. So while intuitive eating may have a lot of draws to people, just stop and think about why you're drawn to it. And if you're drawn to it for the reason, like, oh, this is an easy way out, I can just say that I'm intuitive eating and somehow things will be different for me, probably not gonna work out well for you. Now, if you're going on a vacation and say, hey, you know what? I don't feel like tracking macros on this vacation. I'm just going to intuitively eat. That's going to mean, well, when you go on the buffet on your cruise ship, you're going to start with your protein sources and shrimp, and you're going to eat vegetables and try to have 2 slices of cheesecake instead of 5. You know, like you're really going to reel things in a bit. So anyway, those are our 2 cents on intuitive eating. And if you're an intuitive eater, I still love you. Don't get that wrong. I love everybody, but I also want to help them. And loving somebody is telling them what they need to hear, not what they want to hear. You see that all the time with sports. There's a certain wide receiver who could have had a lot of people in his life tell him the things that he needed to hear instead of the things that he wanted to hear, and he'd probably be a lot better off. But before we dive too far into the weeds, we're going to call this a wrap to the video. And remember, nothing makes us happier than you hitting the like button, commenting your thoughts, even if you're angry and an intuitive eater and want to tell me mean things, boost our engagement, so comment below. And if you like this content and want to see more of it, subscribe to the channel. See you next time.